Okay, so I'm Michael Cross, World Rowing's TV commentator, old former rower, and I'm talking to two dynamic Croatians, Martin and Valent Sinkovic, Olympic champions in the double scull, double world champions in the coxless pair, and on a mission for Tokyo in 2021. Hi, guys.
Hi,
Martin. Hi, everyone who is watching.
So, hi, listen, everybody.
Hey.
Hope we won't be boring.
So, you guys have been back on the water for how long now?
Yeah, we've been rowing since last Monday, so for the past 10 days. We got the permission to go on water.
Still lots of blisters then.
Oh. Yeah.
It's summer for the beginning.
So the grip you had on the ergometer was not the same in the boat, because I know you were training in your apartment on the ergometer.
Yeah, you can put on the erg the same grip like on the water, but it's never the same. I don't know why we always get blisters no matter what we do. If we don't row for 2 or 3 weeks, blisters are back. So we try to put the same grip on the ergometer, but it's just not the same movement. So we always have to pass through that. So it's okay.
Martin, your hand is worse than mine.
My hand is also bad.
Ooh.
Yeah, but I just want to say that we just got used to the sculling and we didn't get any blister anymore. And then when we cross to the rowing, it's like this. Every time we start rowing.
So listen, when you started to row, you came out of the double scull. How did you decide who went on which side?
We do a lot of eight racing in the national championship. And I was in the eight in the junior rowing world championship in 2006. So I was naturally on the bow side and Valent was always on the stroke side. So it wasn't a difficult decision.
And did you ever think, because I know Valent is the stroke man, so he's always sat in the stroke seat. Did you ever try it with you in the stroke seat, Marty?
Yeah, we tried two training sessions. He told me to see it's not going that good.
No.
We weren't satisfied at all, so it's natural for us like this. So we like it.
Yeah. So how was training in lockdown for you? What happened when you went into lockdown and you had that announcement of the Olympics being stopped?
I mean, in one part, it was, of course, difficult for us because we expect to row a lot of races this year and the Olympics. But in the other hand, because we couldn't row, it was relief because we knew that we don't have to race the Olympics without rowing for a month in that year. So, I mean, it's same for everybody, so it's okay. I think we are not that old that we'll have the same situation next year. Maybe even it will be better for us because we'll have more kilometers in the pair. So I think this could be even good for us.
Yeah. Valent, we were talking earlier about Mahe Drysdale because he came up and said some big problems with his motivation when the Olympics were cancelled. Did you have anything like that at all?
Yeah, of course. At the beginning, when they announced that they will move the Olympics, it's hard to stay motivated and to train normally, to train hard, hard intensity. If you know that you don't have any races this year, so I have to say for me it was also the first few weeks tough, definitely tough to find motivation to train. Especially we couldn't go on water, so we need to train on ergs, and it's not easy, especially now. When it's really nice weather in Croatia, yeah. It's sunny, and great spring days, and we need to stay at home to train hard on the ergometers. So it wasn't easy, but after a few weeks, we do the same routine as we normally do on during the winter. So we train similar trainings, and it's important to have the routine.
Yeah.
For me, it works just to have the normal routine, to back the routine. And now when we are on water, it's much easier. Everything is natural and we like it now.
Does the pair feel good? Have you found the magic again after 10 days, or are you still sort of waiting for the feeling to come back a bit?
We are still waiting. I mean, it's much better than after the winter. We are get used to the boat in 3 or 4 days. It's not like in the racing season, but I think it's much better than we expected. So we are happy about that.
Yeah.
I think we are on much higher level this year and this time than the last year and this time. So that's very positive, and I'm happy about it.
Why is that? What have you done to achieve a higher level this time?
Yeah, I think we loosen up a little bit, get relaxed, and have more rotation. We get them longer strokes. And that was the hardest part, switching from double to pair for us. It was definitely the length, to get the right length and to stay relaxed in the boat, because of the balance and everything, it's much more difficult in the pair than in the double. So it was definitely challenging first 2 or 3 years. Even now, we didn't still, I think, get it right as we rode the double. But it's going better. Every kilometers we go much better. And I think that we are better crew than last year.
Whoa. That's quite something. Are you doing flexibility exercises? I saw you have a Pilates teacher.
Yeah, what? Sometimes we are doing that. It's important for the muscles to relax after the training. So I think it's a good exercise, and definitely it's helping us. So,
yeah. So last year at the World Championships in the pair, you won convincingly from the Australians, the New Zealanders and the Australians. So I wonder if we could have maybe a little look at that race, and could talk us through the last 1,000 meters of that race.
Yeah.
If I can find it.
Yeah.
Here we go.
I think the biggest difference now this year and last year is because we have this feeling. Last year, we couldn't find that good feeling till maybe 2 or 3 weeks before the World Championship. And now we have a good feeling in this time of the year. So I think that's the biggest difference.
Yeah. So here we go. So here's the race. So let's see if we can... You can start talking about it, guys. This is from the 1,000 meters.
Yeah.
Great.
I remember in Leeds, we had... really big crowd cheering for us, and the guys from Dubrovnik came, and it was real loud. So every race, we were feeling like home terms, you know.
It was good race for us. I think we have a good feeling all that championship. We knew that we will be first at the 500 and the 1,000, and then the New Zealanders will push in the third 500. So we try to stay ahead of them. In the third 500, then we knew that we can do a good sprint finish.
So you had a good feeling in the boat now, at this point, in the third 500.
Yeah.
we knew our race plan was to get ahead in front of the New Zealanders, because after the semi-final races, we thought that New Zealanders will be our main opposition. And we knew that we have a faster start than them, and we knew we'll be in front. And we just needed to stay ahead in the middle thousand, because they are best in the middle thousand. So we knew they will push us hard in the middle thousand, and that was the key of our race, I think.
So who makes the calls in the boat? Is it Martin? Do you decide what happens, or Valent, do you say anything?
Valent, always Valent.
You're kidding?
Yeah.
Valent makes the calls.
Yeah, Valent makes, and if it's a good race like this, he only makes the call on the last 500 or when we need to get the finish, and that's it. Only one or two words.
And you say nothing, Martin?
No. I'm just pushing hard and try to row as better as I can.
Yeah, for this race, we just had one call. Just one call to start finish, to move up with the rate and nothing else. Because everything was going good. We were pretty satisfied with our rhythm and our length. So we didn't need to do any calling before the finish.
So do you... Yeah, go on, Martin.
I think the biggest difference in this World Championship and the last two is from the day one to the last race, we have a good feeling in the boat. In the 2017 and 18, it wasn't like that. We have a very good race in the final of the 2018 World Championship. But before that, we are still trying to catch on each other, and we didn't have always good feeling. And this World Championship, from the day one, we have a great feeling.
Whoa.
So it was a great race for us.
The last few strokes, the distance became more between you and New Zealand.
Yeah. That's the good feeling when you are first in the last few strokes and you have the bigger ball speed and you know it's over. So that's the best part of the race, if you are in front, of course.
Yeah.
Maybe in 2018, we just didn't do that much of sprint finish. We just want to finish the race first. And here we are talking about if we will have chance to go in further ahead, we'll do it. So we'll push as hard as we can.
You know your racing tactics. You think of Murray and Bond from New Zealand, that they were always the slowest to the first 500 metres. And then they rode a very flat pace through the middle. Have you ever tried doing that?
Yeah, it's hard to do that. But I think when Murray and Bond raced the GB pair, they were always in front. They didn't let them to lead them. So I think when they knew it would be a close race, they pushed more in the beginning. And when they knew they will win it just in the middle thousand, then they don't need to do that much big start.
Yeah.
I admire to them for doing that. I mean, it's in rowing race, it's you need to have a lot of courage to do that, and I really admire to that, because when you are one length behind somebody, you don't see him. So
yeah. How close are you on your times? Have you ever got close to that, the same pace, the world record pace in good conditions, 6:08? Or is that kind of right out there, that time?
Well, we are always, we measure our speed on the trainings compared to our double. And we want to be around 8 to 10 seconds slower. And we think if we do that, that will be a really high level. That will be around world record level. Definitely these last 3 years, we weren't there. We were, I think, about maybe 12 or 14 seconds slower than double. Yeah, but slowly we are getting there. But that's our target from the start, because our coach measure every training. Yeah. Every we do. and he have every speed from the double. And we do similar trainings, and we our goal is to be 8 or 10 seconds slower. So that's our goal.
We was trying to do in the double. Our goal was on the training sessions to do the piece that we can get 6 or 8 on the flat water. Now the goal is 6:16 in the flat conditions.
Yeah.
That's our training goal.
Yeah.
Hope we will achieve it.
Okay. So tell me about the kind of training you're doing now, because it's normally at this time with the hot weather, you will be doing some shoulder pieces, some sprint rowing, and now it doesn't look like there are going to be any races. I mean, what has that meant for the training, and what has your coach, Nicky Bralic, decided that you should be doing now?
Yes, we are doing much longer sessions. And we are doing sessions, normally we do sessions like that right after the winter when we come to the water. For example, today we had a warm up and then 6K 22, 4K 24 and 2K 26. Something like that. We go to the 26, not higher.
Yeah.
This period, because the Europeans are not that close, it's really far, so we'll do some base-oriented training.
Will you not get bored doing that?
The rowing is boring sport sometimes. You have to get used to it. That's it.
Yeah.
It's not always fun. That's normal in the sport, so... I think the main thing is we like to row and we like to train, so it's not always pleasant, but that's the life, that's the rowing. I mean,
we always do some technical stuff, always thinking about technique, always trying to improve, so that's why we think about that, and it's...
So what were you working on today? Give me an example, give the guys an example that are watching. What were you working on today?
Mostly our length, to have a bigger length and to relax in the boat. That we are working last 3 years, but now it's really going better. And now when we have a bad day, when we don't feel a boat, it's going okay. Before, when we had a bad day, it was really, really bad in the pair.
Yeah.
It was a much more difference between good and bad. Then in the double. In the double was closer. When we had a bad day, it was a little bit slower than our best day. And in the pair, it was like this, you know. One day really slow and then one day high. And now it's much more similar.
Yeah, sometimes it's annoying in pair. You know, 2 or 3 days you're going great and then one day it's awful. But that's... As we heard, that's normal in the pair. Everybody is feeling like that. And we are trying to do a lot of work on the front end of the stroke. But if we want to do the perfect front end like in double, we need to be really relaxed and really loose in the boat. And we need to have a good balance. So we are trying to achieve that this year.
Yeah. So that double scull that you rowed, I mean, that was an incredible combination. What made that so good? What made that so consistent?
Yeah, I think it's a good thing that we are brothers. And when you need to row with somebody 5 or 6 years every day, you know, in the training camps, we are living together. So I think that's the... big difference from us and the other doubles. And Nikola Bralic have the really good sense of the technique. And I think that's maybe the biggest difference between us and the others, our technique.
Yeah. We talked about you guys as brothers. You're the perfectionist, Valent, I read somewhere.
Yeah.
And Martin is very stubborn, is that true?
Sometimes.
How? When was the last time you had an argument between you? Can you remember?
Oh, it's good. It's good that I can't remember. So what close?
It was 5 weeks of lockdown, so we didn't see each other a long time.
Yeah.
So now it's everything is perfect.
It's honeymoon for us now.
So because some of the brothers, I think the Searle brothers, one of them jumped out of the boat because he was so annoyed with his brother.
That's the good thing with the brother, you know, you can say to the brother some things you can't to the other. And I mean, he will be mad, but he won't take that really hard, like if he's not your brother. So maybe because of that, some brothers are arguing a lot, you know.
Yeah.
They know tomorrow everything will be okay. He's my brother.
So Valent, if you're a perfectionist, it must be quite hard for you when the level in the pair goes down.
Yeah.
How do you mentally cope with that?
Yeah, I get annoyed. I'm pissed. And that's really funny because outside of the boat, I'm more calm than Martin. Martin, when he's driving, he's always pissed at someone. And in the boat, I'm that one who is always trying to do something. I don't know, sometimes he's pissed when it's not going. And that's really funny. But I'll always try to find some perfect stroke, you know, always looking for something better. And maybe sometimes it's not easy to row with me, you know, because I always try something new, something better. But I think it's working for us.
Yeah. Definitely. So what is the thing that annoys you, Martin, when you're in the boat, or are you just relaxed all the time?
No, I'm annoyed a lot, but I try not to show it because I know it's hard to Valent as well, the same as me. But especially in the pair, most annoying thing is when it's not going good. Whatever you try, when you try harder, sometimes it's going worse and worse.
Yeah.
And I think that's the most annoying thing to me. You know, when it's not going as you planned, you're trying harder, and then the boat is going worse than before, and that's sometimes it's just you want to break the boat and everything, jump out of the boat or something.
You know, sometimes if I think of when I rowed, I could probably count on the fingers of one hand the times where I felt in the zone, where everything was natural and fluid, and it was almost no effort. When was the last time? How often do you guys feel like that, either in the pair or the double?
I think now in the pair, we feel it often, that we are rowing good, you know. Maybe not that feeling that in the zone. I remember the final of the 2018. Martin said that we really had a great feeling and everything. And I remember a training session between semi-final and final. We have just one day. We had a semi-final today, and tomorrow we had a final. So afternoon we had a training session, and we had some big fight with our coach. He wanted us to do more kilometers with him. But I still remember on that training, I felt something really good. I don't know why. Everything, at the beginning of trainings, everything was really bad. And we had a fight. We didn't want to row. We couldn't row normally. And we did, in the middle of training, we did a start, just to practice the start. And I remember I had a feeling it's going better than anything before we done. And then on the finals, we really... First 1500 meters was, I think, fantastic. Maybe our best rowing in the pair.
Do you ever get a time like sometimes? I could, if when I was running in a pair, I could be working really hard, and the guy in the bow man, he was finding it easy, and sometimes it was the other way around. Do you ever find that one of you is really tired and really trying hard, and the other guy is just finding it all very easy? And
ever? Sometimes, but I think the best thing when the best is when you are when you're tired the same, you know. If you understand, you're pushing the same and everything is the same. Sometimes it's like that, especially in the bowman. For me, sometimes it's easier in the during the stroke, but it's not good because when it's easy for me, I know it's not going that good.
Yeah.
So the best is when you are tiring yourself as the same as the stroke man, but it's hard to achieve that in the pair.
Okay.
So and for the when you're talking to the zone, for me, I just want to say that when it's going very good, when it's going everything as you planned, I never feel it in that moment. Maybe after the training, when I think about it, that was in the zone, because always when I'm on the training session, I always think about what I do, and I can never enjoy that as hard as after the training when I think about it, what I did.
Okay.
You know, you're always focusing on something in the technique or something. So because of that, I like to do the bike. I'm not thinking of anything, just driving the bike and
yeah.
In the rowing, you're always thinking about the technique or something. So
it's strange. It's that I'm opposite. I feel it in the boat. I don't know. That's really strange. Sometimes I feel that we are moving the boat the right way, you know. We are not just pulling, we are not just pushing everything, that we are just moving the boat.
Yeah.
I don't know, that's the feeling we want to achieve.
So people have asked how many training sessions you do each week.
12. We have tried to do the 15, I think maybe in 2014 and 15. Then we were doing the Monday, Wednesday and Friday, 3 training sessions a day. And our coach said that he don't like it, that we are not focused enough on the training sessions. He like to do it less, but more efficient. So he said, I'm not happy about that and stop doing that.
And did it work?
Yeah. I don't feel any difference now and then. Really.
And have your... Because I saw a presentation about your ergometer scores coming down as you got... You're in the quadruple as you, you know, down to 545, 546. Yeah. Are you still improving?
Now we are on the same level every year. Around... 546, 547, around that. Our best was Martin best was 545 and my 546, and we did it. Do you remember, Martin? 2017
or 16, something like that. I'm not sure.
Maybe,
yeah. I think Eric Bond and Murray had the same idea. They always were on the same level in the ergo. They couldn't drop it any lower.
Yeah, it's hard sometimes. I mean, we always try to beat our score, because if you are trying to do the same, you will go down. So we are always trying to improve, but we are happy if we stay on the same level. So it's unrealistic to think that you will be much faster than this.
It's quite interesting to listen to you, because from in Britain, at the British squad in Caversham, they train, you know, maybe 15 sessions a week, very, very hard. They're very competitive as well. And I'm thinking, you know, particularly this year for selection for Rio, it was, you know, battle, battle, battle. They had a really tough selection process. But you have nobody really. I know Damian Martin maybe in the single, you might do some training, but you train less and you have less competition. than those guys in the British squad.
Yeah, but we don't do too many kilometers of water in 1 week. I think we do maybe 130, 120, around that. But we don't ever row easy, you know. We always doing something hard. Yeah. And we are concentrated on technique very much. And our coach wants us to every kilometer that counts, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah. Maybe we are... we don't do that much kilometers, but we do it really hard and really good. So maybe that's some compensation, you know.
Yeah. Yes, go on, Martin.
It's interesting because it's totally different philosophy, and it's the same success of us and the British team. So, you know, it's somebody likes something better than other guys. So you can't say something is good and nothing else is good, you know, because sometimes we would like to have some sparring partner. It would be good for us. But, you know, if every day is some competition, you can't relax and you can't think of your technique that much as we can. So everything have the plus and the minus side.
Yeah. So one of the questions I had before the interview was to ask you about your psychological preparation. Do you have any help with the way you mentally prepare for races, or do you do that all with Nicky Bralich? Do you have maybe a psychologist or someone like that?
Yeah, we don't have it. I think we are both really good under pressure, and we always do our best on the races, and we didn't need to have any help till now. We'll always do our race playing with our coach, but I think we are both mentally tough, and we can handle the situation by ourselves.
Yeah. Do you guys remember your toughest ever race?
Mentally.
Or mentally or physically. I mean, if you ask me, I can remember the hardest race I had was one time. It was a semi-final in the World Championships, but.
I remember my hardest races were in quad, definitely. A few races, I remember 2011 World Cup in Munich, second World Cup or first World Cup. I think it was first World Cup, 2011. I was dead after, I couldn't move, and they did the transfusion. And a few other times in the quad. Because I wanted in the quad, I was the stroke, and three guys were behind me. And if something weren't going good, or somebody was in front, I wanted to pull the other guys, you know, to start something better. And then I was really dead before the finish line. And a few times it happened to me.
Yeah.
And in the double and the pair, never that happened to me.
How about you, Martin?
I don't remember what is the toughest race, but I think that the psychological thing, more than physical. Sometimes when you expect that the race will be pretty close and hard, and if it wasn't, it will be easier. Maybe in your head it will be easier than...
Yeah.
Then the other thing, and sometimes when you expect easier race and you have to push to the end, it will be harder than you expected. So maybe it will be harder race. So
okay, I don't remember,
but I remember in Rio before the finals. For me, the psychologically was much easier than I supposed it will be. I always think it will be hard preparation psychologically. I don't know what we'll feel before that, but it was really easy job before that race. I don't know why.
How do you guys feel about talking us through your final in Rio then? That Olympic double sculls final.
Yeah, why not? It's a very interesting race. Yeah.
It's always
nice
to see that.
Yeah, okay.
Wasn't going as planned.
Yeah. So I will.
Yeah, it was very rough conditions, a very big headwind in Rio, and especially in the heats, it was crazy hard conditions. Weren't rollable.
Okay, so here.
Yeah, I will just say before the race, our race plan was. We knew that Lithuania will be our main competition, and we knew they are very fast in the first 500, like us. And we wanted, no matter what, we wanted to get in front of them. And I think maybe that was our biggest mistake, because we lost too much energy in the first 500, because it was very wavy and we didn't row so good. We just pulled as hard as we could. And that's why we spent a little bit too much energy in the first 500.
Yeah, maybe we didn't do the technique as we planned to do it. So, but we managed to go ahead and it cost us in the third 500. But we spared some energy for the finish. So it was good in the end.
So how often do you practice in water like that? Because the waves seem really strong.
Not that much, because on the Jarun Lake in Zagreb, where we normally train, there is no, it's never like this. But I think if you row good, you will row good on every conditions, because that year, if you remember the Brandenburg, it was much harder than this on the European Championship. And before that, we didn't have any rowing in that conditions, any rowing in rough conditions, always on the flat water, on the Iron Lake. And we row very good on that conditions. So I think if you have a good technique, if you row good, you'll row good on every conditions.
So, Valent, have you said anything in the boat up until this point, or are you just quiet? Or what are you thinking?
Yeah, till now, everything was as we expected. We expected to lead a little bit. But I remember that I thought I wasn't feeling that good after first 500, a little bit more tired than normal. And it was a little bit not good. I didn't know if I'm going to last till the end, you know.
Yeah.
It was really hard wind, and it was really hard to row.
How nervous were you for this race? Because you got the silver medal in London and you wanted to be the Olympic champions. You'd had a great sort of few seasons before this. You were the favourites. Were you nervous for this race?
I mean, as I said before, I was less nervous than I expected. I didn't think about that we are world champions 2 years in a row and something like that. I was just trying to prepare myself as best as I can and on that race and to row my best in this race. I didn't think about what will happen if we lose, what will happen if we win. I was just trying to do my best on the race and not to think about what will happen or what will not happen after the race. So I think that was good for me, because I wasn't that nervous as I expected. Maybe 3 or 4 weeks before the Olympics, I expect to be very nervous before the final race. I was maybe more nervous before the final of the World Championship in 2015, year before, than on this race.
Whoa. So what is going through your head as the Lithuanians come up in the third 500? What are you thinking? What is going through your minds?
Now we did the first big push. After 1,000 mark, we did a really big push, and it didn't happen. Nothing has happened. They're already catching us, and they were past us now. And that was really. I thought maybe we will lose this race. First time in the double, I thought maybe we will lose it, but because after that push we were dead, and they were still had a better speed and still rode in front of us, so we were really in a bad place right now.
Yeah, same for you, Martin.
Yeah, the same. I really think we will lose this race in this moment because we are pushing as hard as we can and they passed us like we are standing still. They were really, really quick in this part of the race. And in the first time in the double, I think we will lose the race.
Yeah. When you're aware of Tufte and Borsch behind you, or were you just focused in your boat? And,
no, only on the 20.
Yeah, we didn't see at all, just Lithuanians. And,
so,
now we just wanted to do our best, you know, not even thinking of winning, just to push everything we had, and we'll see what will happen at the end. As Martin said, now when we crossed the last 500, I still didn't believe that we will win. But we said, let's go now, try to push everything to do our best and we will see. And right after, we were start to catch the Lithuanians and now we knew we have them.
And where did
you find? In this moment, we knew we will be first.
Yeah. But they were really good crew that year. Especially, they didn't throw any regattas before. And they were really great crew.
So where did you find that magic from? Where did it come from?
I think from all the training sessions, good training sessions we've done before. So I think all the experience before that and all the training sessions and technical drills were paying off in this time.
I would say maybe they were more than we are.
More tired, probably, yeah.
Because after first 1,000, we didn't have much energy left. So apparently that Lithuanians had less than our.
So, yeah. Martin, your hands went up. Valent, he collapsed in the boat going forward.
Yeah. That's the only thing I could do. This and it was a really hard race. But I want to talk about that feeling when we crossed the line.
Go on.
I don't know. Maybe you can tell your story when you crossed the line first in the Olympics. I was thinking before the race, if I will win, I will scream, I will do something, I don't know what. But then when I crossed the line, I was more calm than enthusiastic or euphoric or something like that. I was really just, I will enjoy this moment and I like it. And it was really calm to me, not some screaming or something. It was really, now I can relax.
You know, you say that when we crossed the line first in Los Angeles, I literally felt nothing.
Absolutely. Yeah.